In this video, I'm going to be talking about the Samsung Odyssey G3 Best Settings. It's a very easy process, so make sure to follow along. In this video, I'm going to present what I believe are the best settings for your Samsung Odyssey G3 monitor. Keep in mind that even though this monitor is designed for gaming, and the settings that I'm going to cover in this video are also directed for gaming, you will still be able to use it to enjoy watching videos, watching movies, and other stuff. So, all that you have to do is use the buttons underneath the monitor. So, there will be physical buttons that you can press to open this menu here. So, instead of changing the settings inside of Windows or inside of your TV console and so on, go over here to this Samsung menu. The most important things are always going to be available under Game. The very first thing that you will see is the refresh rate. This should be set to the highest amount possible. The higher the refresh rate, the more buttery smooth the game is going to feel. So usually you will see 120, 144, or possibly higher, like 165, depending on the model that you have. Just set it to the highest amount possible. If you are using a DisplayPort cable, you will be able to unlock those very high refresh rates. So, if on HDMI you are limited to 120, you could have 144 and 165 locked behind DP. Keep that in mind. Afterwards, for response time, you want to set this to the highest possible. So, usually you will see fast, faster, or even extreme. Because the G3 has a VA panel, it has something called ghosting, where stuff moving quickly across the screen will have a trail effect behind it. By maximizing the response time, you will be able to minimize those artifacts. So set it to extreme if you can, and if you notice anomalies, lower it to faster or fast. FreeSync Premium should be enabled, especially if you are gaming. So if it is off, set it to on. Black Equalizer can be set to the default, which should be 13. If it is not, just set it accordingly. And the other stuff can be left on automatic. Virtual Endpoint should be set to off, and if you go over to the picture tab, you can change stuff like the contrast, brightness, and saturation. In my opinion, this is all down to personal preference. I like to have a very sharp and very colorful image, but this is going to differ from person to person. So spend some time here and make the changes according to your personal preferences. But the most important settings for gaming and overall usability are going to be under game, and it's the ones that I showed you. I hope I was able to help you on the best settings for the Samsung Odyssey G3. If this video helped you, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more very easy tips. Thank you for watching.